guys, this is Matai of the Dead again with the third and final inside look at the editions that Rapid Eye Movies sent me. Please click links down below, guys, to go check out Rapid Eye Movies. They're a really nice little distribution label here in Germany. Also, check out my previous reviews, both on YouTube and the blog, for the other releases that I received. And again, I will be posting a review of this on the blog with screenshots and photos of the release. So if you guys want to check that out, please click those links down below. So for this third and final one, we're looking at one of the Pinky Violence films. And this is, of course, Stray Cat Rock, Sex Hunter, starring Mako Kaji. Again, not a review of the film itself. There's countless reviews on YouTube and on the internet if you want to know about the film. This is purely for any potential collectors. So before I, ramble on too much, let's just get straight into it. So as you can see, it's another slipcase with a digipack inside. And again, really nicely designed. Really nice and simple front cover. I absolutely love that typography. Then on the side, you've got the same typography, and on the back, you've got stills from the film, and also a description about what you get. Like I said, it is a German release intended for the German public, so really only if you're a fan of this film, or if you want some aged exploitation, or if you know Japanese or German, then I can't really recommend these releases to that many people, but true collectors out there should definitely check them out. So we've looked at the outside, it looks really nice, so let's have a look at the digibook. So here we have the front of the digipack, which I stupidly called a digibook, but whatever. And again, really nice simple photo from the film with a nice design on the side of it. And also you've got the Rapid Eye Movies logo in the bottom. Then at the side, you've got pretty much the same design as the outside of the slipcase. And then on the back, you've got a really awesome still from the film again, with this nice border going along it, which of course continues onto the whole thing. So overall, you've got a nicely designed slipcase. However, on the inside, unlike the previous two editions, there really isn't anything going on. But the good thing is, it works, and you've just got simple typography there. The disc is simple. It's just simple inside, so you really cannot complain. So we've had a look at the edition itself. Let's have a look at the extras that you get. Once again, you get the leaflet. Well, the pamphlet, I should say, which talks about as Zatoichi meets the one-armed swordsman, which is apparently out in March. I'm not too sure whether that was this year or last year, but yeah, very nice. And again, you've got the simple design from the inside of the digipack. And then, of course, you've got the postcards from the Stray Cat Sex Hunter. You've also got one, I'm guessing, from the film that I reviewed last time. Then you've got Zatoichi vs. One-Armed Swordsman, Lady Snowblood, and, of course, Female Prisoner Scorpion. Again, another assortment. Like I said, I don't know if these are random or if every release of this film will have these ones, but they're just a nice little addition, whether you want to use them or not, whether you want to frame them potentially. I don't know, it's just a nice little addition to have. So if you just give me a second, guys, I'll show you the poster. And here we have the poster, which I have to say looks absolutely fantastic. You've got a really nice mix of colours and typography and photos from the film. Just absolutely gorgeous. The one thing I would say is I would actually prefer this artwork on the front of the release. It looks a lot better than the slipcase, not calling the slipcase bad or anything. But this is just really, really nice. Again, this would look really nice framed with the other ones. And then on the back, actually a little bit disappointed with this. There's no stills, it's just purely information about the film. You've got the design that's throughout the release on the edge. But yeah, overall, this back part could have been designed a little better. But to be honest, that's really clutching at straws to find something wrong with this release. So yeah, really nice little poster. So that concludes this trilogy of videos, guys. This is was of course for Stray Cat Rock Sex Hunter, which is, I believe, a Pinky Violence film. like I said, this really isn't for everyone. You either need to know Japanese or German or need to be a real collector to have this in the collection. But like I said, it would look really nice if you started to collect these on the shelf. They're not too slim, but they're not too big. So it'll make a nice collection piece. Great features. If you want to see detailed photos and also stills from the film to see the transfer, please check out the blog post down below, and feel free to check out the previous videos and blog posts that I've done for the films that Rapid Eye Movies have sent me. They've done a really great job with these releases. I can't thank them enough. So guys, please go check out Rapid Eye Movies. You can search them on the German Amazon, and you can find their releases there as well. Check out the website, check them out on YouTube to see trailers for their releases. And yeah, if you've got any questions, feel free to ask, but all links down below should answer any questions that you may have. Check out the blog post, check out the Facebook page as well. On Mondo Squallido, just search it. The links are down below. And hope you guys have enjoyed these videos. These releases are absolutely awesome. And until the next time, you're all awesome.